Good evening, students. So welcome to Anacademy Amset YouTube channel, students. So myself, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, biology educator on Anacademy Amset platform, students. In today's class, we'll be discussing about the topic that is biotechnology. We will discuss some multiple choice questions in today's session. So before starting this session, I would like to introduce about our Anacademy Amset class courses, students. So students, recently Anacademy Amset has reduced its Anacademy prices by 40%. So let us see what is importance of this particular. So they have reduced the price by 40%, students. So let us see what are the different prices. And if you are interested, you can use my code Rajendra and purchase this course, students. So you can use my code Rajendra, students. So let us see the different price plans of our courses. So if you see the 1 month trial plan, so 1 month trial plan is costing around 1500 rupees per month, and whereas 3 months trial plan, so 3 months trial plan is costing around 3750 rupees, students. So 3 months trial plan is costing around 3750 rupees, and 6 months trial plan is costing around 6000 rupees. So 6 months trial plan is costing around 6000 rupees, students. Whereas 12 months plan, so 12 months plan is costing around 8250 rupees. Whereas 24 months plan is costing around 12,000 rupees. So this is about our Anacademy's plan, students. So if interested, you can use my code Rajendra Live and you can get 10% discount of the given amount. Actually, so amount is for 1 month. If it is 1,500 rupees, so in that you will get 10% discount, students. So try to use my code Rajendra Live so that you will get 10% discount on the above given prices. So let us see what is the benefits of taking Anacademy Plus subscription. So let's see what are the benefits of taking Anacademy Plus subscription, students. Okay, students. So premium content. So premium content will be available at affordable price. So structured live courses and dedicated live doubting sessions are going on, students. So quizzes will be conducted at regular intervals. So if interested, you can use my code Rajendra Live to purchase this particular Anacademy Plus subscription, students. So there is already few batches. Batch course has started. If you're interested, you can join these batch courses, like later batch for AMSET 2021. So that is for the students who are preparing for medical engineering entrance examination, that is in part of AMSET. And another batch is also going on, that is called as a leader batch. If you're interested, you can join this batch, students. Then there are other batches are also going. So rapid revision Telugu batch for AMSET, so that is also going on. So for physics, chemistry and biology, you can join those courses also if you're interested, students. So apart from that, if you see that there is a daily free practice test series is also going on, students. So daily 20 questions will be available on our website. Like it can be physics, it can be chemistry, mathematics or biology. So that you can take it. So it will take 20 minutes. So that particular test duration is 20 minutes. You can practice the test and evaluate your performance, students. And you can attempt anytime if you want for your practice. So these all are absolutely free, students. So this is how. So now this is how to attempt the test series. So you can click on the for plus subscribers. It is you will be having the full-length mock test also will be available, students. If you're interested, you can use my code Rajendra Live and purchase these courses, students. So this is about our Anacademy AMSET plus courses, students. So let us discuss about today's topic on biotechnology applications. Let us see some multiple choice questions regarding this topic, biotechnology applications. So let us see the first question. So consumption of which of the following food can prevent the blindness. So blindness associated with the vitamin A. So blindness. So which of these foods? So out of all these, we have to find out which is associated with the prevention of blindness, that is associated with vitamin A deficiency. So vitamin A deficiency can be supplemented. Means deficiency means vitamin A is supplemented in the food in the form of golden rice. Actually, in golden rice. So the name itself is given as golden rice is because it is rich in the vitamin A. So it is prepared to recombinant DNA technology, and the golden rice has vitamin A. So that will be certainly helpful for the people who consume this rice. So good evening, Abhinav. So welcome to an Academy MSET YouTube channel. So today's class we're discussing some multiple choice questions and biotechnology applications. So the first question the answer is golden rice. So golden rice is supplemented with vitamin A, so it can prevent the blindness associated with the deficiency of vitamin A. So that is about this particular question. Let's move to next question. So Bacillus thuringiensis strain. So Bacillus thuringiensis, which is called as BT strain. So BT strain has been used for designing novel. So it is used to design. So BT strain. So Bacillus thuringiensis is a bacteria. So it will secrete the toxin which will kill the insects actually. So that is the reason. So that was used to kill the insects. So that is acting as a bioinsecticide actually. It will only kill the insects. It doesn't destroy the plants actually. It will kill the insects. So Bacillus thuringiensis BT strain is an insecticidal plant. It is means it is a bioinsecticide. So it can kill the insects. So when this bacteria release toxins, and that toxin is especially poisonous to the insects, so it can kill the insects. So Abhinav, what is your question? Yes, hello Anand. So welcome to an Academy MSET. So 160 options be 40. So Adi Man Chaplay Abhinav. We cannot exactly tell that all the questions means out of the 40 questions, out of 160 questions, 40 questions will be option A, option B. We cannot say exactly like that. It depends certainly. So that probability we cannot expect. Okay, let's go to next question. So BT toxin. So BT toxin kills the larva of certain insects. So just now we're discussing BT toxin means the toxin that was produced by the Bacillus thuringiensis bacteria. So that will kill the larva of certain insects. How it is killing the larva of certain insects? That's what the question is. So this particular BT toxin, released by Bacillus thuringiensis, this particular larva of insects, when they consume the leaves of the plant. So in the leaves of the plant we have this BT toxin gene. So that will release the toxin inside the gut of the insect. So when the toxin is released inside the gut of the insects, what happens is this BT toxin, by binding to the activated toxin in the midgut of epithelium, it will create pores. So it will create the pores of the gut. So gut pores cannot create chases, that leads to swelling and lysis. That leads to finally swelling and lysis. Because of that, what happens? The insect will be dying. So based on that, we'll take option A as answer, students. Okay. So BT toxin is killing the insect. Now that is the question actually. So BT toxin gene is present in the leaves of the plants. Okay. And when these insects feed on the leaves of the plants, the inside the leaf material which goes, the food material of the plant, which is a leaf part, that goes to the gut of the particular insect. In the gut, the BT toxin gene present in the leaves, that will release the BT toxin, and the toxin will be creating holes to the gut of the particular insect and will kill the insect. So it creates the pores and lead to swelling and lysis. So option A will be answered in this case. So let's move to next question. So cry protein is obtained from cry gene. So what is this cry gene? So cry gene is the gene. So it is the name of the gene. So name of the gene that was obtained from Bacillus thuringiensis. Okay. So the name of the gene that is from the Bacillus thuringiensis. Okay. So thuringiensis, which is acting as insecticide. So the gene which is acting as insecticide, that is called as a cry gene. So the cry gene is obtained from the organism that is called Bacillus thuringiensis. Okay. So cry gene is the gene that is responsible. So responsible for the releasing of this particular toxin. Next. So BT toxin is harmful to which group of insects? No, that is the question. So BT toxin, Bacillus thuringiensis toxin, just now we have seen how it enters into the gut of the insect and how it create pores in insects and kills the insects, we have seen. Now let us see how it is harmful to the insects. So which group of insects it is harmful? So it is harmful to the insects like Lepidopterans, so Coleopterans, Diphtherans, and all the above. So of course it is all the above is the answer here. So BT toxin is harmful to the insects. It is harmful to insects like tobacco budworm, armyworm, beetles, Diptheras. So all this, well, all the cities applicable actually. So that is the reason we have to take answer as option D will be answered in this case actually. So let's move to the next question. So RNA interference. So RNA interference technique, so which is called RNAi, has been devised to protect the plants. To protect the plants from nematode is silenced by dash produced by the host plant. So host plant is producing something, some molecule, and that molecule is protecting the plant from nematodes. So that is the question. So what type of molecule it is producing? No, that is the question actually. So in RNA interference, what happens is the host plant produces double strand RNA, and that is called as RNA interference actually. So double strand RNA is produced by the host plant so that it itself protect from the nematode actually. So that is the answer. So option C will be answered in this case, students. So let us see the next question. The first clinical gene therapy. So first clinical gene therapy given in 1992 to a 4 years old girl was with enzyme deficiency of. So the first clinical gene therapy was given in 1990 to a 4 years girl with a deficiency of which enzyme? No, that was the question. So it was due to deficiency of enzyme. Name of the enzyme is called as adenosine deaminase. So adenosine deaminase is the first enzyme. Okay. So first clinical gene therapy. So it was the first clinical gene therapy was given in 1990. So for the person who has deficiency of adenosine deaminase actually. So option A will be answered in this case. Yes, Anand, what is your question? So when MCET exam will be conducted? So Anand, actually MCET examination date schedule was not yet released in the AP. Okay. So because after NEET examination only, we will be having the MCET examination. The AP MCET examination will be in the after NEET examination only mostly. So that is the reason they are waiting for the NEET announcement, date announcement. Then after that, they will give the MCET dates actually. Okay. So that's what about AP MCET actually. It is for AP MCET. Let's move to next question. The protein alpha-1 antitrypsin is used to treat. So the protein alpha-1 antitrypsin used to treat emphysema. So it is used to treat the disease. The name of the disease is called as emphysema. So the protein alpha-1 antitrypsin used to treat the emphysema. Now that is the right answer. Okay. Now let's see the next question. So GAC stands for. So what is this GAC stands for? Now that is the question actually. So GAC stands for what? So GAC stands for Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. So this is the full form of GAC. It is Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. Now this is the right answer. So Genetic and Environment Approval Committee. Okay. Option C is answer. Okay. Option D I have clicked actually, but option C. So Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. Now this is the right answer. Option C is the right answer. Students, this is GAC stands for Genetic Engineering Approval Committee. Yes, Anand, you are right. It is option C. Now can I try to answer this question? So which patient, when patient with a deficiency defective ADA was treated, which of the following steps were performed for gene therapy? Now this is the question. So which is the right answer? Yes, can try to answer this question, friends. So when a patient with a defective ADA was treated, which of the following steps was performed for gene therapy? Now this was the question actually. Yes, friends, can you answer this question? So when patient with a defective ADA was treated, which of the following steps were performed for gene therapy? Now this was the question. Let us see the options. So let us see the first option. Lymphocytes were obtained from the patient. Yes. Now this statement is correct. Lymphocytes are transferred to the cultural dishes. Yes. Now this is also the right statement. Lymphocytes were transfected with normal ADH gene, yes. Now this is also right statement, and this is the most crucial statement actually. Now this is the most crucial statement in this treatment actually, this gene therapy treatment. Now this is the most crucial treatment actually. Okay, so lymphocytes are treated and transfected with the normal ADH gene. So a normal ADH gene is transfected to the person who is suffering with a defective ADH. Okay, so then what happens after? Now this transfected cells are returned to the patient. Yes, now these all statements, all the statements are correct students. So based on that, we'll take option A as answer. Yes, yes, very good. So option A is the right answer. Okay students, option A is the right answer. Next. Match the following and choose the correct combination. So match the following and choose the correct combinations, which is the correct combination from the given question. So column A and column 2, we have column A and column 2. So Escherichia coli, Bacillus thuringiensis, Rhizobium, Milorotti, Sacrobacter tumefaciens. Now Escherichia coli, so what it is going to do? Bacillus thuringiensis, Rhizobium, no, that was the question. Okay. Yes. So in this case, if you clearly see Escherichia coli act as, it act as a vector actually, it act as a vector. Okay. So it act as a vector. Bacillus thuringiensis, okay, in Rhizobium milotti has nif gene actually, Rhizobium has nif gene, so C will be 1, Bacillus thuringiensis, it is producing toxin, so B will be 3, and Acrobacter tumefaciens, act as a vector, yes, it acts as a vector, and Escherichia coli cannot be actually interferon, so there is some mistake is there actually, this is not applicable. Okay, so there is no right answer actually in this particular question. If you see Bacillus thuringiensis, no doubt it produces BT toxin. Okay, then Rhizobium, so Rhizobium, in Rhizobium the gene is called as a nif gene, so nif gene is for, this is a gene responsible for nitrogen fixation, so the gene responsible for nitrogen fixation is called as nif gene. So what is the importance of nif gene? The gene that is responsible for nitrogen fixation. So interferons are the protein particles, these are protein, okay, proteins produced, these are proteins, antiviral proteins actually, these are actually antiviral proteins. So antiviral proteins produced against virus, so they are produced against the virus actually, so that is the reason they don't have relevant option is not there for this particular thing. Then Bacillus thuringiensis BT toxin and Acrobacter tumefaciens, yes, it is a vector, it is acting as a vector for the plants, used in recombinant DNA technology, okay, in RDNA technology it is used as a vector especially for the plants actually, okay, so that is the reason. Okay, so probably if this is removed, then we can go for option C as right answer. Okay, option C would be the right answer. Okay, if that was removed. Okay, next question. So match the items with column 1 and column 2. So column 1, if you see, said column 2. So column 1, genetically modified crops, flavesaver, biopiracy, and E. coli. So genetically modified crops. Genetically modified, GMO means genetically modified organisms, GMO. So GMO full form is genetically modified organisms, genetically modified organisms, GMO is genetically modified organisms, genetically modified organisms is GMO. So flower saver, so genetically modified organisms, they have flower. Biopiracy and so E. coli, you know, that is the question. Now if you see genetically modified organisms are used in recombinant DNA technology, genetically modified organism is used in recombinant DNA technology. Then flower saver tomato, yes, yes, Anand, you are right, option A would be the right answer. Flower saver tomato, now this is increasing the shelf life period. Now biopiracy, okay, so it is a bio resource, and E. coli is involved in production of insulin, which is called as a humulin, so that insulin is also called as inulin, okay, So that is the right answer. Next, let us see the next one. So match column 1 with column 2 and identify the correct options. So column 1, so gene therapy, biofertilizer, BT cotton and humulin. So once again, so gene therapy, biofertilizer, BT cotton, humulin. No, that is the question. So gene therapy. So gene therapy is used for which one? So biofertilizer, which is acting as a biofertilizer. So BT cotton. So BT cotton. Okay. So if you see humulin. So humulin is used for treatment of diabetes. So no doubt about it, is for treatment of diabetes. Then BT cotton. So BT cotton, the Bacillus thuringiensis is gene, that is cryogene. Okay. So biofertilizer, which is acting as a biofertilizer, rhizobium acting as a biofertilizer. So gene therapy, severe combined immunodeficiency disease. So SCID means severe combined immunodeficiency disease actually. So first one is D. So A is 3. Then B is 1. So option B will be the right answer. C will be 2, cryogene, humulin is 4. Okay. So option B will be the right answer, students. Okay. So Anand, option B will be the right answer in that case. Okay. So you can clearly check. So gene therapy. So severe combined immunodeficiency diseases. Those can be treated by gene therapy. Biofertilizer. So like rhizobium act as a biofertilizer because rhizobium synthesize the, it fix nitrogen. So rhizobium fix nitrogen, so it can act as a, so nitrogen fixation. So it can act as a biofertilizer. So BT cotton. The gene present in BT cotton is called cryogene. Okay. So humulin. Humulin is used for treatment of diabetes. The commercially produced insulin is called as a humulin. Next one. So match the column 1 and column 2 and choose the correct options once again. So golden rice, BT toxin, RNAi and rosy. So once again, so try to answer this question, students. So golden rice. So golden rice, BT toxin, RNAi, rosy. So golden rice. So golden rice, BT toxin. Okay, so once again, if you see rosy, so rosy is the first transgenic cow, is rosy. So first transgenic cow is rosy. RNAi is called as gene silencing. So BT toxin is cryogene, golden rice is rich in vitamin A. So based on that, we'll take the answer from this particular question. So rosy is the first transgenic cow. So RNAi is involved in gene silencing. BT toxin as a cry protein, golden eye rich in vitamin A. So based on that, we'll take the answer. So yes, very good. So option A will be the right answer, students. Option A will be the right answer in this particular case. Now let's move to the next question. So match the column 1. So match the column 1 with column 2. So match the column 1 with column 2 and choose the correct option. Now that is the question. So column 1, if you take column 1, you have some list of terms. Forensic science, ELISA, probe and alpha 1, antitrypsin. Okay. So and one trypsin. So we know that very easiest option out of all is ELISA. ELISA is a test used. ELISA is used to identify AIDS. Then alpha 1 antitrypsin, just now we are discussing this point in today's class. Alpha 1 antitrypsin used for treatment of emphysema. Then forensic science, so it is part of DNA fingerprinting. Probe is a radioactive DNA or RNA. So based on that, we'll go for our answer. So forensic science is involves the DNA fingerprinting, is one of the most applicable one. Then ELISA test is used for, ELISA test is to identify the AIDS, AIDS. Then probe is a radioactive DNA or it is RNA. Then alpha 1 antitrypsin is for emphysema. So based on that, we'll go for the option D as a answer in this case. So that is about this question, students. Let us move to the next question. So let us see the next question. So which of the following is the correct set of labeled A, B and C, D given in the figure? So A, B, C, D actually, okay. So if you see A, So this part, now this part is the C part. Now this part is insulin. Now this part is insulin. Okay. So peptidases, proinsulin. Now this is proinsulin. Proinsulin has three parts actually. Proinsulin has three fragments. Okay. So proinsulin. Now this peptidases, because of action of peptidase enzyme, it cuts this useless fragment. Now this part is not used, not part of the insulin. Okay, now this is cut. So option A, in this case option A will be the right answer, students. Okay. Now next question. So silencing of mRNA has been used in producing transgenic plants resistance to. So silencing of messenger RNA has been used in producing transgenic plants. They are resistant to nematodes. So they are resistant to nematodes actually. So they are resistant to nematodes. So that is the right answer actually. Okay. So silencing of mRNA has been used in producing transgenic plants resistance to nematodes. Now let's see the next question. So which one of the following technique made it possible to genetic engineer living organisms? Which of the following technique is made possible to genetic engineering in living organisms? So genetic engineering of living organisms, that technique is called as recombinant DNA technology. So recombinant DNA technology involves the engineering of the living organisms. Now that is the exact answer actually. So recombinant technology is the technique that involves that makes it possible in recombinant DNA technology. So option A will be the right answer in this case, students. Okay, option A will be the right answer. Now, which of the following BT crops is grown in India? Okay, so BT crops grown in India by farmer, and of course the best known, that is called as a BT cotton. So BT cotton is the best known, which is the cotton which is growing all over India and it is resistant to the insects. Okay, so BT cotton is the right answer. Next question. A transgenic food crop which helps in solving the problem of night blindness. So night blindness, we'll discuss in the same type of question in today's class also. The transgenic food crop. So which transgenic food crop out of all these is helped in solving the problem of night blindness? So it is, of course, no doubt it is a golden rice. So golden rice is the rice crop. So that is the rice crop which is used to prevent the night blindness problem actually. So that is the right answer, golden rice. Next. Genetically engineered bacteria. So genetically engineered bacteria has been successfully used in commercial production of. So we were discussing in today's class only about this question also, the E. coli. So genetically engineered bacteria, nothing but it is the E. coli, is used as a genetically engineered bacteria and it is used in preparation of human insulin. So it is called as a human insulin, which is also called as a humulin. So it is also called as a humulin. We have seen that also in today's class. So it is called as a humulin is the right answer. Next. So biotechnology deals with industrial scale production of biopharmaceuticals and biological products using genetically modified. So genetically modified. So biotechnology especially deals with genetically modified. It can be microbes, it can be fungi, it can be plants and animals. All these above will be the answer in this case. Okay. So biotechnology deals with industrial production of biopharmaceuticals, biological products. And all the products like microbes, fungi, plants and animals, so all the above will be applicable in this case actually. Okay, so that is the right answer. Next. So BT toxin is actually, of course it is a protein. So it is intracellular crystalline protein. So BT toxin is the intracellular crystalline protein strength. So very very important question you have to remember. So these are today's multiple choice discussion on the biotechnology application, students. So These YouTube classes are only for half an hour. You can join 60 minutes class on our Anacademy MSET app, students. There is a link is also provided in the description box. You can click the link and you can use my code Rajendra Live and join my free special live class, students. If you're interested for subscription also, you can take subscription by using my code Rajendra Live, students. So before closing the session, once again, I want to show you our Anacademy prizes. Okay, students. So prizes are very, very, very of less amount, students. So this type of this much reduction no website gives. So try to understand this and utilize the available resources for very less amount, friends. So 1 month trial plan which is costing for 1,500 rupees, and if you use my code Rajendra Live and purchase this 1 month trial plan, Rajendra Live, you should use, students, then you will get 10% discount. Out of 1500 again you will get 10% discount. So certainly will benefit for the students. So yes, Anand, this week I'll be taking classes. You can join, you can check the app regularly. So mostly day after, not day after, mostly day after tomorrow, like that I'll be starting the classes after 1 or 2 days. So this month, okay? So you can join those classes. You can check the timings on the app. I'll be soon, okay? So soon I'll be scheduling the sessions. You can check Anand and you can join my classes. Okay, thank you, students. Thank you all of you for joining the classes. See you in the next class.